The evolutionary biologist J.B.S. Haldane liked to say that God has an inordinate fondness for beetles because there are so many of them. One reason for the staggering diversity of insects is that an enormous number eat plants, and there are 250,000 plant species to choose from. Most insects feed in a very specific manner and attack just one plant part. Beetles often cut neat windows in the middle of leaves. Caterpillars and sawflies chew ragged holes from the outside in. Leaf skeletonizers consume everything except a delicate network of leaf veins. The tiny larvae of leaf-mining flies and moths eat their way through leaf tissue, widening their tunnels as they grow. To shield themselves from birds and parasitic wasps as they eat, leaf-rolling caterpillars secrete sticky, spiderweb-like strands, which pull the leaf into a tube as the webbing shrinks. Or they glue adjacent leaves together to make a protective sandwich, within which they construct a conical home out of their own droppings. What if you can't find any evidence of herbivory on the leaves in your backyard?
You would think this is a great sign, because isn't this wonderful, healthy-looking milkweed? Beautiful, luxuriant leaves. But actually, the fact that there's no herbivory on these leaves, there's no cuts, no holes, tells you that there are no monarch caterpillars feeding on it. Nothing's feeding on it.
An absence of herbivory may mean that you only have introduced ornamental species, which native insects don't like to eat. Or it may mean that the insects in your yard have been decimated by pesticides or climate change. And that's a warning sign for our own well-being. So herbivory in moderation is not only fascinating, it's a sign of a healthy environment.